Good day everyone, Mr. Cargill here with our next AutoCAD video. Now in this video, I will be showing you how to do your foundation plans. Alright, so to do the foundation plans, we are going to copy the walls for the floor plan and put them on a separate drawing. So first, let me just open a different drawing. So just click on the plus sign here that says new drawing. Let me fix this. Alright, you won't have to go through this because you won't see this. On yours, you'll just see the new blank screen. Alright, so when you come to this new drawing now, you are going to set your units on your limits. So type units, click on units, change precision to 0. This should be millimeters, not 0.00. Millimeters international, okay. Then set your limits. Based on the size of the floor plan, the foundation plan is going to be roughly the same size as the floor plan, so you can use the same limits. So the lower left corner is always 0.0. The upper right corner can be 35,000 by 35,000. Alright, good. So we have our limits and our unit sets. So let's go back to floor plan. Alright, so we're going to copy the walls and bring them to our next drawing. But we only want the walls. We don't want the dimension. We don't want the door. We don't want the windows. So what we're going to do is to freeze the layers that we don't want. So we're going to click up here on layer. Click on the drop down right here where it says freeze or thaw. We're going to freeze them. So freeze the dimensions layer, the doors layer, and the windows layer. Alright, so when you do that now, you realize that those are all gone. So all we have are the walls. So now we can copy the walls. So we're just going to highlight them. And then right click. Clipboard. Copy. And then go to this next drawing. And right click. Clipboard. Paste. Alright, and we just click up a point to place it, and here it is. Alright, so now we can start doing the foundation plan. Alright, so let me just get rid of this line right here. So all first thing we're going to do, all these spaces right here, we're going to close them up. So the foundation plan doesn't have any open spaces, so all of these spaces right here, we're going to close them up. So let me do that. So just bring this out like this. Or you'd have to ensure that you have ortho turned on and you have perpendicular turned on. Also endpoint and midpoint. So ensure you have ortho turned on. Ensure that you have perpendicular and midpoint and endpoint turned on. Select line. Again, click here. And just come here. Alright, so line again, bring this down to there, and this as well. Alright, so your foundation plans are going to be different from mine, obviously, because your floor plans would have been different as well. So your foundation plan is based off your floor plan. Alright. So now let me just trim up a few things. Trim this and this. And then I can delete the rest. And delete those. Oh, let me trim out this right here. Alright, that's good. Alright, so let's join the rest of the walls. Just deleting these. Alright, so now we have all our walls closed. Let me just delete this and trim that. Alright, so now that that is done, we are going to offset our walls by 150 on both sides. So this wall, I'm going to offset it by 150 here, then this wall, offset it by 150 inside. Alright, and when we offset it, what we're going to be drawing are the foundation footing details. But because the foundation footing is underground, you're not going to be able to see it when you're looking down. So you have to put it in broken lines, because as you know, broken lines represents things that are there, but you're not able to see them from your viewpoint. Alright, so now let me just offset those. So instead of clicking on each wall, each line and offsetting them, I'm just going to join all of them. I'm just going to click on all the outer walls. And then I'm going to join them by pressing J, enter. Alright, so I'm gonna press J, enter. So now they're all joined and it will treat them as one. So when I offset it, I can just do it one time. So click on offset or type offset, and the offset distance is 150. So 150. Click on the object and bring that out like that. Alright, good. Alright, now we can offset the internal walls as well. So let me just offset all of these. All of the internal walls, I'll set them as well. I could have joined them and I'll set them as well. But let me just do this. All of them. Alright, so I'm just offsetting the walls right now. Did I miss any? Yeah, down here. And here. And this. And here. And yeah, this one is good. So I think that's all of them. Yeah, that's all that it was. Alright, good. So now like this one, I can just extend it since they don't meet. And then extend this one to meet it up here. And do the same for this as well. Just extend this. Bring this to meet it. Which other one? I think it's just those two. Alright, good. So now we can trim out what we won't need. So TR, enter, enter. Click in these places to get rid of these, get rid of that as well, this right here, also this, and this right here, over here. So all these extra pieces here, I'm going to trim out all of these. Alright, so I'm just trimming out all these extra pieces. Think I only have a few left. Wait, I think I trimmed the wrong thing. Or did I? No, it's good. So I should, yeah, I will just extend that and bring it there. Okay. Alright, so let me just extend this and bring it out to meet this wall here, and then let me trim this, and that's it. Alright, so there we have it. Alright, so we can create a new layer for the outer walls, give them a new color, and they should be broken lines because, as I said, they're underground, so you won't be seeing them. So let's create a new layer. So click on layer properties, click here to create a new layer. Let's call this layer footing. All right and change it from white. You can use any color. Let me use blue. All right and change it from continuous. So click on continuous, load, select ISO dash, okay, and click on ISO dash here and click OK. Alright, so now we can close this. So all of these walls are going to make them into the correct layer, the outer ones. We're going to put them in the footing layer. So just click on all of them, all of these outer lines, all right, I'm just trying to get all of these outer walls. Alright, good. I think that's all of them. So now we're going to click on that, change it from the zero layer to the footing layer. And now there are blue with broken lines. Line doesn't look broken because it's, yeah, but if you scroll down, yeah, it's broken line. Alright, good. So there. Alright, so we have that. So now, this is what we're going to do. We're going to create what we call stiffeners, and they are used for strengthening the foundation. We have the I-type stiffeners, L-type, and the T-type. So let me just draw those very quickly. So just select a line. So the I-type is like this. Choose a place to start. The I-type is 300 down, then 150 across. I typed 3000 instead of 300. So let's do that again. Alright, so the I type is 300 down, then 150 across, 300 up, and then you join it back there. So that's your I type. Then we have the T type. The T type is 450 across, 150 down, then 150 across, 150 down, 150 across, 150 up, 150 across, and then I just join it there. Good. So then we have the L type. So we're going to do the L type is 300 down, 300 across, 150 up. Sorry, Yeah, 150 up, then 150 across, then 150 up, and then you close it off right there. Okay, let me trim off that. Alright, good. Alright, so now that's our stiffness, but we need to put, we need to hatch it. So you're going to come over here where hatch is, you're going to click on hatch. Alright, and then the hatch that we're going to use for that is the concrete hatch. So once we do that and this comes up, we're going to click on this arrow right here, this drop down arrow. We're going to click on AR concrete here, ARCONC stands for concrete. So just click there and just click in here to paste it, and then click here to paste it, and then click here. Alright, good. So if when you put in concrete, you realize that it looks kind of like this. Let me see. 0.005. Yeah, if you realize that it looks something like this, it's because the arch is too, it's the scale isn't right. Alright, so if you realize it's that, it looks something like that, just full white, you just double click it and change the scale to something bigger, and then you will see it. Alright, so now that's that. But now, if you realize it treats everything as one, so if I want to move this here, it's going to move everything, and I don't want that. So what I'm going to do is to separate them. So I'm going to highlight them, and I'm going to click explode. And now, if you realize it treats everything differently. Alright, so now let me do this. I'm going to highlight just the L type and click join. So now it treats the L type as one. Do the same for the T type, just highlight it and press J for join and press enter. And then the I type will do the same. J, enter. Alright. So they're all good now. So now we're going to place them in. And they put them in the corners of the walls, except for the I type. For the I type, you put the I type along the wall. So like this wall right here that is so long, I'm going to need to put probably two on this wall. The rule is that you don't want to have like 10 feet. You don't want to go 10 feet without having one. Alright, so let me put them in now. So let me put in this L type first. So let me just highlight this and select the copy tool. Copy it from either here or down here. Alright, from here. Alright, so I'm gonna copy it, turn off ortho. Alright, and then paste it here. Good. Alright. And let's just paste this one here as well. Alright. And yeah. Good. So I'm just paste this here. And we're going to rotate this. So let's highlight that and click rotate. Turn on back ortho. Because we're going to be placing it here. So we're going to rotate it like this. Alright, so now we can highlight it and we can copy it and bring it here. Alright, and where else? We need one here and we need one here. Alright, so let's rotate this. So click on that and rotate it from here and rotate it like that. Now we can copy this from that point and bring it down here. Alright, and oh, we need one here as well, so I'm just bringing this over here and rotate it. Select the rotate tool, click on the end right here, and rotate it like this. Wait, this, yeah. Then highlight it and copy. Click here and bring it down here. Alright, so that's good. So we need one more L type right here. Alright, so let me just use this one. Okay, just move and move it from here and bring it to right here. Alright, so now that's all our L type stiffness inside the foundation. So now let's put in our T-types and I-types. These are very expensive to put in, so you don't need to put them more than you need to. So since I have one here, I don't necessarily need to put one here. Or since I have one here, I don't need one here. So let me put a T-type right here and one here as well. Yeah, because this wall is very long, so I'm gonna need one here. Alright, so I like this. Copy it. I'm just bringing it to a different area so I can work with it there. Alright, so I'm going to rotate it now. I'm just going to highlight it and rotate. What you can do to make it easier is just to have a bunch of them rotated in different directions. So I can just rotate this one like that. Then copy it. I could have mirrored it. Copy it, bring it over here, and then rotate it. So I have them facing all directions. Left to right, up and down, so that I don't have to be copying them all the time. So now let me rotate this like that and then copy this. So I'm just gonna copy this and then rotate this one to be facing up. All right, rotate and no, so let me just delete this one. Alright, so that's it. They're just gonna copy them and rotate them. Alright, so let me copy those two. And then I can rotate this. Like that. And then rotate this down. Alright, good. So now let me put these in. So this one, highlight it, copy it from here, this point, and bring it to here. Wait, I clicked on the wrong thing. So let me undo that. To undo, just Control Z. Alright, so when I highlight it, scroll down, when I select the copy tool, scroll down and ensure you click on this point and you don't click on one of these things. Alright, so click on that point and then bring it here. Alright, good. And then highlight this and copy it. Click on here and bring it here. Where else do we need a T-type? Do we need one here? Yeah, let's put one there. Alright, so I like that. Click on the copy tool. Copy it from here. And bring it down here. Is there anyone up here? Yeah, let's put one here. So, this one. So I like that. Select the copy tool. Copy that and bring it over here. Alright, so I think that's good in terms of T-types, because we have one here, so we don't really need one here. Alright, so our I-types now. So let me just copy this. Alright, so copy it. Let me bring it out here and bring the next one up there, and let me just rotate this one. So that, yeah, that. Alright, so now let's put in these. So let me highlight this and copy it. come here and let's put it here somewhere in the middle there. All right, and let's put one on this wall. So click the copy tool, click here, put it, wait, let me copy it from the midpoint and put it to the midpoint on the wall. So let me do this then, let me do that, highlight it, select copy, copy from the midpoint right over here, and place it on the midpoint of the wall, there. So it looks uniformed and evened. So I should do the same over here. So let me copy this from here, from this midpoint, and bring it to here. Oh, I shouldn't have copied it. I should have pressed move. So let me just delete this. Alright, so very good. Alright, and then we can put one along this wall since it's so long. So let's select this one, copy it from the midpoint and bring it here. Let me see there. Yeah, all right, and then we can also put one, let me see this wall. Yeah, we can put one in this. No, that wall doesn't necessarily need one. Let's put it down here because this is an external wall. All right, let me do this. And on this wall as well. Oh, we needed to put an L tab here. And we need about two on this wall. So I'll just do this. That's good. Yeah, I think that's good. And then let's put an L tab here, and then we're finished with the stiffness. Oh, this wall doesn't have any. All right, so let's put a T tab here. Oh, yeah, let's put a T tab there, since this wall doesn't have any at all. All right, well, let me put this L one here first. So. Copy and bring it here. Good. All right. So then now, yeah, let me put on C type there. Alright, and that's how you do a foundation plan. Alright, so in the next video, I'll show you how to do the dimensioning for the foundation plan. Hope you enjoyed the video.